Hello guys, welcome back to another Android app development tutorial. In this episode we are going to learn about what is the difference between implicit and explicit intent. I will show you the difference with an example. So here we have an application. We have three activities available in this application. We have a main activity, activity A and activity B. In main activity, we have two buttons. First button is for starting activity A. Second button for starting activity B. This is the layout for activity A. This is the layout for activity B. We are going to start activity A using explicit intent and we are going to start activity B using implicit intent. So you can start an activity by its class name, that is called an explicit intent. So by using explicit intent, you have to use the exact activity class name. For example, you can start an activity present in your own application using an explicit intent because you know the exact class name. But in some situation, you want to start some activity without its class name. For example, you want to send some email, but your application does not have an activity that is capable of sending email. In such situation, you have to start some activity present in some other application for sending email. That is an example of implicit intent. So by using implicit intent, you can start an activity present in some other applications also. So first I will show you what is the use of explicit intent. So we are going to start activity A using explicit intent. So this is the onClick method for starting activity A. So in this case, we are going to use explicit intent. We know the exact activity class name. So create some intent. First parameter is context. Second parameter is the target class name. Create this activity A.class. Now we can start the activity and pass the intent. Now test the application. Now click start activity A. So it is start activity A. So this is example of explicit intent. We can start an activity by using its exact class name. Now we are going to start activity B using implicit intent. So if you want to start some activity using implicit intent, that activity must have some intent filter section in Android manifest.xml. So go to Android manifest.xml. This is activity A, activity B, and here is the main activity. So we need to start activity B using implicit intent. So we have to specify some intent filter for the activity B. First needed argument is the action. You have to specify a general action for this activity. So this activity is capable of sending some data. So I use the name as action sent. Now you have to specify category. I specify category as category default. That means this activity is capable of getting launch request. And final one is the data. You have to specify what type of data this activity can send. This activity can send some plain text data. Okay, so for activity B, we specify some intent filter. Now you can start this activity B using explicit and implicit intent. But here we are going to start activity B using implicit intent. So go to main activity. This is the onClick method for start activity B. So specify some intent. Now we have to specify the action for the intent. Set action. We need to send some data, so I specify it as action sent. Now we have to specify the type of data that we need to send. Set set the type into text plain. Now we have to attach the data to this indent object. For that, create some variable. Hello world. Now attach this data to the indent object. For that, use this method put extra indent put extra text. Now pass the data message. Finally, we can start the activity using start activity method. So here we start the activity using an implicit intent. Here you can notice that there is no activity class name is used here. Instead we use the action. Okay. So now we can run the project. Now start activity B. So here there is a pop-up is appear. And some other applications are also listed. Drive, message, Gmail, Bluetooth, etc. That means by using an implicit intent, you can start activity present in some external applications also. So here we need to send some data. In this device, there are some other applications that contain activities capable of sending data. That's why this pop-up comes up. Our application is listed at the top. So that is the main purpose of implicit intent. You can start an activity without its class name. Also, you can start an activity present in some other application. So I select an activity present in our own application. So select just once. So it is start activity B. So this is the difference between explicit and implicit intent. By using explicit intent, you can start some activity using its exact class name. By using implicit intent, we can start some activities using some actions. This is the difference between explicit and implicit intent. I hope you understand the concept. If you have any doubt, please specify that in the comment section below. If you like the video, please subscribe this channel now. Thank you for watching.